I am a casual chart watcher, and I have to say, there are a lot of things happening on the charts that I'm happy about. Blurred Lines is no longer number one, awesome, and Lords Royals is in the top 10, also awesome. Another thing to note is that Eminem has another song which debuted at number 3, Berserk, and it's okay. That's how Eminem has been lately, okay. A lot of fans find his current stuff nowhere near as good as his past stuff. My take on Eminem? I was never really a fan of Eminem when he was trying to be funny, but when he was serious, I liked him okay. But there was one point in Eminem's career that everybody wants to forget. The Encore album. An album so bad, his two later albums are called Relapse and Recovery. But is it really as bad as the rumors make it seem? Let's review it and find out. This is Encore. After a minute-long intro, the album starts proper with a song called Evil Deeds. Thankfully, this is just the song's title and is not direct foreshadowing for later. Truly, this song is more weird than bad. Among other things, this song includes Mary Had a Little Lamb. Weird flow and repetition. Mama had a baby and its head popped off. 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 And an almost silly sounding chorus. Father, please forgive me, for I know not what I do. I just never had the chance to ever meet you. It's not awful, it's just really, really weird. Track number 3, Never Enough, featuring 50 Cent and Nate Dogg. This song is okay overall. I enjoy the beat, and the two guest stars are okay. There's not really anything noticeably bad about it. What? Seriously? That's just silly. Track number 4, Yellow Brick Road. No, not quite. This song is about one's journey, not going to the Wonderful Wizard of Oz. But this song could have easily been called, like, Roads, or Railroad Tracks, or pretty much anything else. The Wizard of Oz just doesn't seem very Eminem. But besides the name, the flow is fine, and I enjoy the production for the most part. This song actually does get a thumbs up in the end. Track number 5. Like Toy Soldiers. Once again, I like this song. This is actually probably the best song in the album. I like the beat and I like the message that it's trying to convey. You know, I have to say, I don't really see the spectacular badness that this album is supposed to have. Maybe this won't be that bad after all. Track number 6, Mosh. This is the encore that I expected. I just like that it sounds like Eminem and the beat are fighting. Not only is the flow really awkward, it sounds like Eminem is aware of how loud the beat is, so he's compensated by yelling and emphasizing everything. I do give credit to the song for sounding just as plodding and unpleasant as the situation that it describes. Overall, this is a pretty bad song. Track number 7, Puke. For any of you who think that this song's title has a deeper meaning, it literally begins with him puking. This song is a song about how much he hates his girlfriend. He hates her so much that it makes him puke. Once again, it feels like the title could have been something else. But the main impression I get from Puke is patheticness. I mean, seriously, just listen to this chorus. This song, more than anything, sounds whiny and miserable. It's a pukey song about puke, plain and simple. Track number 8, My First Single. This is where the music starts to get really, really bad. It starts out with him flat out mumbling instead of rapping, and then we get one of the most sickening choruses of all time. It includes burps, awful singing, farting, and this. This isn't even music anymore. He's just filling up space in the chorus. The flow is really bizarre as well. He said that this was supposed to be his first single, but thank God it wasn't. This song is Poo Poo Caca.
AM, it's Paul.
Track number 9, Paul. This is a skit. This is pointless album filler, and I really don't see why you need to pad an album that is over 70 minutes long. Paul doesn't even have anything interesting to say. Move along! Track number 10, Rain Man. This song is even more proof that Eminem really needs to stop trying to sing. The worst part about it is that he spends the entire second verse ranting about absolutely nothing. He's not even rapping or trying at all at this point. He's just wasting time. And he straight up admits that by the end of the song.
And I ain't even gotta make no goddamn sense. I just did a whole song and I didn't say shit.
This song claims that the narrator has no brain, and I totally believe that. Track number 11, Big Weenie. After doing his Pee Wee Herman impression, he starts out this diss track, and let me tell you, this is the worst diss track I've ever heard. It's not focused. He goes on completely bizarre tangents, it's completely stupid, and it's totally incompetent. It feels like he's just filling up bars with whatever. This is terrible. I can see where Nicki Minaj got her inspiration for Stupid Ho. If Nicki Minaj at her worst is better than you, you need to rethink what you're doing. Track number 12, M Calls Paul. Yet another pointless skit, this time with poop. How charming. Track number 13, Just Lose It. This is the first single of Encore, a song that confused and horrified Eminem fans everywhere in 2004. I don't even know how to describe this song, it is just terrible. There are ridiculous tangents, unbelievable lyrics, and one of the most obnoxious sounds in the history of audio. I don't know if it's supposed to be a laugh or a scream, but either way, I would rather listen to somebody scraping two pieces of styrofoam together. And also, for a song called Just Lose It, it doesn't sound particularly crazy. It's just stupid and awful. Blackpool Sita, this is not. Track number 14, Ass Like That. Honestly, I don't even know what I'm doing anymore. I mean, what the hell is this? This is by far the worst song on the album. It has awful, immature, inane lyrics that sound like they were written by a fourth grader, awful flow, and one of the most racist accents I've ever heard. Like India doesn't have enough stupidity to deal with. I mean, is this even an album anymore? Is Encore just one colossal prank that way too many people fell for? I would believe that. I cannot fathom anybody in their right mind ever thinking that this is funny, clever, good, at all, in any way, shape, or form. This song is one of the worst songs I've ever heard in my life. And guess what? This was a single. This song makes me want to have a lobotomy. I hope you're happy, Marshall. track number 15, Spend Some Time, featuring Obi Price, Stat Quo, and 50 Cent. Oh, thank God, a decent song. I mean, it's really stupid. Some of the lyrics are awful, and the chorus is pretty grating. But at least I don't want to kill a kitten with a shard of this CD. All four of the rappers do okay, and while the execution is really vulgar and stupid, I admire the message that this song has. It's okay. I have never been so happy to experience adequacy in my life. Track number 16, Mockingbird. This song is also okay. I mean, I know I should be happy that I passed the awful part of the album, but it just annoys me even more. He has the ability to make passable songs. Why is half of this album horrible flow and poop jokes? But it's not like this song doesn't have any problems either. Really, Eminem? First, Mary Had a Little Lamb, then Yellow Brick Road, then Mockingbird. This album is considerably less gangster than I thought it would be. Track number 17, Crazy in Love. I'm a little bit confused about what this song is even about. If it's a hate song, it's not a very good hate song, and if it's a love song, then it's one of the most backhanded love songs ever. But that being said, I like the production in this song. I enjoy the chorus and the beat as well. Why is it that the relationship song is better at conveying insanity than the song that's about insanity? That just doesn't seem, you know, right to me. Track number 18, One Shot, Two Shot, featuring D12. Crap. We're back to crap again, aren't we? This song is about as appealing as the shootouts that it describes. None of the D12 members that have verses are very good, but Eminem blows them all out of the water with the same stupid, rambling, nonsensical tripe that's polluted this entire album. This song is both literally and metaphorically sounding like it's trying to shoot itself. And I really hope it succeeds so I don't have to listen to it anymore. Track number 19, Final Thought. I originally thought that this was stupid and pointless, seeing how it's just Eminem walking around and it doesn't even have any final thoughts in it. And then I thought about it a little bit more. It's pointless, drawn out, stupid, and gives the audience absolutely nothing. It truly is Encore in a nutshell. Song number 20, Encore. I don't really have that much to say about this song. I really don't think that this was, like, the standout song, like, even good or bad. It's just okay, kind of boring, really. It's kind of like the transition between the awful Eminem to the okay but kind of boring Eminem that we kind of have today. I really don't have that much else to say about this song, and thank God the album is over. That was Encore. I can safely say it was one of the worst things I've ever had to review for this show. Some of the songs are decent, but the middle of the album is just torture, plain and simple. It's really sad to see Eminem stoop to this level because he does have talent. And I hope that after this review that you will not need to listen to this album ever. Will Eminem ever truly recover from Encore? I don't know, but after all this, all I can do is pray that it doesn't get any worse. See you next time.